Hey y'all, welcome back. Got on my Saint shirt today and got my Saint coffee mug here in hand. So that must mean we're going to talk Christian hard rock and heavy metal, even though we're not going to talk about Saint today. But over the last several months, I've had opportunity to pick up some great new vinyl, some remastered re-releases of some vinyl, some crowdfunding vinyl, and then also some original vinyl. So I've had an opportunity to kind of build my collection a little bit over the last several months. Thought I'd just share about some of those with you today. Some great Christian hard rock heavy metal, a little bit of country acoustic material in there too, and some blues, Eric Clapton-ish kind of music as well. So let's just dig in, take a look at that. I'll see you on the other side. Welcome back to the TimRisto.com vlog video series. I'm Tim Risto. Like I said, I've had opportunity to get a bunch of vinyl over the last several months, kind of expand my collection. I'm really enjoying collecting vinyl. It's just a lot of fun. For me, Christian music and even movie soundtracks were what I started to listen to as a teen. And I listened to them on vinyl. That's what I started with. That's what was available. That's what was popular back in the 80s. And so I was listening to a lot of vinyl. I collected mostly vinyl. I was getting into cassettes and CDs a lot too, but a lot of what I collected was vinyl. So it's got a nostalgia factor for me. It's what I started on. I just kind of love getting back into vinyl again. And so I've had opportunity here over the last several months to get some more vinyl to expand my collection a bit. And there's been some really good stuff out there. So one of the first ones we're going to talk about is Mark Hurd's Dry Bones Dance. This was crowdfunded through, I believe, Indiegogo. And I supported the campaign and picked up this particular vinyl edition, which also comes with a digital download edition. But this is Mark Hurd's 1990 album, Dry Bones Dance, which is really good. But they remastered it, so it's brand new. It's even got some demo tracks on it as well. Put out by Low Fidelity Records. I kept a little hype sticker for that. Mark Hurd started out as kind of an acoustic and then a rock guy. He went into a little bit more, maybe a little slightly alternative. Later on, when he formed for a single album, a band called Ideola, and then at the end of his career, this was the first of his last three albums. He went into a little more of a country, Zydeco, acoustic, folk kind of sound, with still some rock overtones to it. But this is one of my favorite of his albums. Dry Bones Dance, there was this one, then Second Hand, then Satellite Sky was his very last album. And then sadly, he passed away from a heart attack. I think he actually had it on stage, but then passed away shortly afterwards. They figured out a short time later that he had a heart attack, or confirmed that he had. And he passed away sometime shortly after that. But these last three are kind of considered his great albums. And you can see why musically. Was just getting a very rich style of music, accordion and mandolin, and just a variety of musical kind of folk, country, acoustic styles. Really, really good stuff. Lyrically, he's just always been amazing. So they remastered this edition. The cover art and back cover art kind of match the original CD release. This is a gatefold edition. So it's got some really neat interior gatefold artwork with Mark Hurd there, and it's a double vinyl release, black polyurethane paper sleeves, and I got this gold smoky kind of vinyl edition of it. They had it available in a couple different, of course, color variations, and I believe there's some still available post crowdfunding campaign release. I think there's some available on maybe Low Fidelity Records website. I'll look that up and put a link in the description. But I got the gold smoke edition. It's kind of hard to see the smoke. It's a little more, I shouldn't say gold, orange smoky edition. It's a little hard to see the smoke in it. It's a little more orange than smoky. But anyway, these sound really, really good. We've got an insert with picture and some liner notes on one side with the Great Monument Valley photograph there that kind of became a staple for its release. And lyrics on this side. Just some really good material. Second disc here. Again, that orange vinyl. Such a great album. Songs like Rise from the Ruins that started out. The Dry Bones Dance is one of my favorite. It's the one that kind of first caught my attention when I listened to this album back in the day. This was from 1990, by the way. House of Broken Dreams, Our Restless Hearts, Strong Hand of Love, Everything is All Right. But the one I've been listening to the most lately is Lonely Road from Side 2. Man, that's just such a great song. In fact, you listen to some of the lyrics on that. You know, Hurd was just such a great lyricist and writer. His music was great, but his lyrics were even more probing and introspective and spiritually challenging on so many levels. Lonely Road for me is just one of the greats. Starts out here, not taking note of the fools or the wise, being a pawn of time and chance, not making vows when the floodwaters rise, is simpler than nails through your hands. Being a slave to the sultans of grief, keeping the hand to the plow, being held captive to public belief, is easier than thorns through your brow. And it's a lonely road, and it's a lonely road, and it's a lonely road that the Son of Man walks down. And it goes on from there, but it's just all about that whole journey of Christ to the cross, basically. You know, the nails in his hand, the spears in his side, and that road that he walked down for us, for all of humanity, to die on the cross, and then to rise again. But just how lonely of a road that must have been. Love the way that he puts us in kind of Christ's perspective of that journey, of that trip to Golgotha. Just really great stuff. And all his songs are like that. There's just kind of that deep, introspective, spiritually challenging material. And Lonely Road's just been speaking to me a lot lately. It's been a great, great song to listen to. Side 4 has some demos on it included in this vinyl release and in the CD and digital download release, I believe, as well. So it's got 6 demos from 1989. First one is Waiting for Dry Bones to Dance, which is an early precursor version of the Dry Bones Dance song. And it sounds very different. And so it's really kind of a treat to hear that one. And then it's got House of Broken Dreams, Our Restless Hearts, Nobody's Looking, Lonely Road, and Mercy of the Flame demos on here as well. And those are, for the most part, I haven't listened to them in great detail yet. I need to kind of listen to them again. But I did a first pass on all those. And those are pretty similar to their final versions on the album. But what a cool treat to have those on here as well. This is a great album if you're into country or, you know, folk music or acoustic kind of country rock. This is a great, great release, and you just can't go wrong. Mark Hurd has really got some good stuff. So check it out. There is still some vinyl, last I checked, available post crowdfunding campaign. And of course, there's CDs and digital downloads as well. But this is really a phenomenal album. I understand in June or July, they're going to do another crowdfunding campaign for his last two albums. So Secondhand, that followed this, and Satellite Sky, that followed that, both of which are also great albums. I'm not as familiar with Secondhand, but I do love Satellite Sky a lot. So I will probably support that campaign as well. Mark Hurd's just got some great stuff. In fact, listening to Dry Bones Dance got me back into Mark Hurd again, so I went looking for one of his earlier albums, one of my favorites of his earlier albums, and that's Victims of the Age. This is from 1982. This was him more in his rock phase, which I also really loved. At first, I was a little disappointed when Dry Bones Dance came out and he was a little more country, and I was like, yeah, I don't know about that. But really, he retains a lot of his rock roots, and the sound is so good, and the music and writing is so good that he won me over. But I still love Victims of the Age. It's a little more of its time, slightly, but there's still also just a universal quality about his rock music, and I really, really like that. But there's so many good tunes on here, too. The title track, Victims of the Age, is a classic. Faces and Cabs, Nothing is Bothering Me, is a little more kind of blues style, I guess. Dancing at the Policeman's Ball is a classic. I think that song single even went, was popular for a long time in the 80s and maybe 90s on secular radio or mainstream radio, and went beyond Christian circles. Also, Heart of Hearts, last song, is pretty good. But this is a very, very good album as well. And so this is an older vinyl, original vinyl that I picked up after listening to Dry Bones Dance again. So Mark Hurd, great stuff. If you haven't heard him, check him out. He's really got some wonderful material, great music. Okay, next up is one of my all-time favorite albums. And I've had this one on CD for years, just got the deluxe edition of it on CD. But they put the vinyl out again. I think this has been on vinyl before. Lost Dogs, Little Red Riding Hood, their second album from 80-something, 90-something. They don't have the year on the back here, but this vinyl here was released in 2019. Limited edition pressing of 650 copies, but this is just such a great album. For those who don't know, Lost Dogs is a band that formed out of three or four other bands. A member of Daniel Amos, a member of the choir, a member of Adam Again, and maybe Undercover was the other one. I can't remember for sure now. Anyway, four or five guys that formed from other bands, they came together and formed Lost Dogs as kind of a side band. But I think in many ways it became more popular than their primary bands after a while, at least for some of them. But this was their second album. It's rock, acoustic, blues, there's a little pop. Just a variety of different styles, especially their first two albums. Their third album normalized a little bit more, and their fourth one, Gift Horse, was a little more country and acoustic, but this one was still kind of a variety of styles similar to their first album. But it's just a really, really good album. Here's the back cover art. This came up available again on their website. I hadn't seen it for a while, but I don't know if they reprinted some more, but I got an email about this, and I quickly ordered it. This is a nice gatefold edition, very cool, two vinyl, two LP edition. Great songs like No Ship Coming In, Imagine That, Dunce Cap is one of my favorites, Eleanor It's Raining Now, No Room For Us, Pray Where You Are, just some really, really good stuff.
I saw you, I knew what I knew, that I could be nowhere without you. Working on a song till my fingers were blue, determined you'll know there without you. And if I could fly, and if you would stay for are we all?
I just love it. It's just great, great stuff. This edition is great too. The vinyl is this red splatter vinyl, very, very cool, and sounds really good. Two disc edition, but also has a an insert with band photos and artwork, cover art, and then lyrics inside. So it's a very nice gatefold vinyl edition. I really love it. If you haven't checked out Lost Dogs and you like a little more of that kind of classic rock or country, acoustic rock and alternative rock, there's a little of that in there, blues and stuff like that. They're just really a really cool band. The amalgamation of these different members from these different bands came together and really formed something special. So I love Lost Dogs. They've got about 10 or 12 albums out now. I think they might be done. Their last one was released, I think, in 2010 or something. So I think these started, I'd have to look, I think these started in the 90s maybe. But great stuff. That's one of their best albums right there. So check it out. That should be available at Lost Dogs on their Bandcamp website. They still had some stuff in their store there. So check them out. All right, another great release. Or re-release, reissue, remastered, is this one by the Prayer Chain called Mercury. It was their second album, and I just picked this up on vinyl from their website. I got an email saying they had some vinyl in stock again, and these things usually sell out pretty quick. One of the great albums, Prayer Chain, was known in the 90s for their first album, Shawl, which was really more of a grunge-style alternative rock. And that became very popular, kind of was the namesake for the band. And then the second album, Mercury, came out, and it was quite a departure from the style. There's still some grunge elements in here, but this is more of, I don't know, experimental, alternative rock, a little more Pink Floyd-ish in terms of its, there's a lot of different ideas and kind of flowing of music, and very different from the first album, although there is enough connective tissue to where you can recognize it as Prayer Chain, but much more experimental. And I really love this album. Musically, it's phenomenal. If you're interested in rock and alternative rock and experimental kind of music, just open to different musical styles, this really, I think, would appeal to you. I think it's their masterpiece, frankly. It's just very, very good and really well done. So I had a chance to get this on vinyl. I was trying to get the gatefold release, but they were already sold out. So I did get this single sleeve edition with two LPs. So even though I missed out on the gatefold, I was able to get the color that I wanted in the vinyl, and that's this blue hue color that matches some of the album art. And then they also had an insert in there with band photo and lyric sheet. Music is just so good on this. It's hard to describe. You really have to listen to it, and you got to listen to the album from beginning to end because it's really good. Doesn't necessarily flow from beginning to end like a Pink Floyd album does, although some songs do lead into the next. But stuff like Hum, Water Dogs, Creole, Mercury, Bendy Line, and Sunstoned, which is my favorite one, the closing track on the album, is just so good. It's great stuff, very I think this came out in 97, I believe, something like that. You know, so it's got more, a little more 90s vibe to it, but it's just some great, great music. So if you get the chance, see if they still have some vinyl available. They still had some of this vinyl edition available last time I checked. Go check it out. Get it on CD, whatever. Just listen to this album. It's one of my all-time favorite albums, and it this is a masterpiece in terms of mainstream music or Christian music. It's just really that good. But you got to be open to a little different style of music, and be a little patient with it, because again, it's a little bit longer songs, longer tracks in some cases than what you might be used to in just a 3 or 4 minute song, but just well worth your time and effort. Great stuff. All right, last of the new old stuff, the remastered, re-released albums that I picked up that are new, and then I'll switch over to some of the original vinyl that I picked up. But the last of these are these three recent releases from Girder Records of the first three DeGarmo and Key albums. Remastered by Girder on vinyl. They also did remastered CDs, which are already out. I picked those up, but the vinyl just arrived here recently. DeGarmo and Key's a great band. They started out, you know, Memphis blues style band. They were a little more acoustic and some keyboard driven in this first release here, this time through, but still had a heavy Memphis blues feel to it, and I love the style. This is a little more a product of its time. This came out in 1978 originally. This remastered edition just came out this year, like I said, a few weeks ago. But it's still very good. If you can get past a little of the some of the keyboard stuff that's a little more dated, there's just a lot to enjoy here. Songs like Emmanuel, Too Far, Too Long, Only the Meek Survive, Alleyways of Strife is great. Wayfaring Stranger is a phenomenal version.
I'm just a poor wayfaring stranger, traveling through this world below. Lord, I swear there's no pain. I know there's no danger in that bright world to which I go.
I really like this album. It's a great first album for a band. You know, you look back at like Petra's first album, and that was, you know, definitely a product of its time, a little more just rock and roll kind of album, and it had different influences too. That one is just a little harder for me. I do like it, but it's a little harder for me as a first album to appreciate compared to this DeGarmo and Key one, which I think was a great first album for a band. Always wished that before they finished their recording career, that they'd come back around to doing another album like this to kind of close things out. Love this album here. The Girder release comes with a nice sleeve with credits and liner notes and lyrics on the other side. And this edition is in a nice orange vinyl, matching some of the color tones of the sunset and the artwork. So really nice first album edition. It sounds good too. It's a little more brighter sounding. I don't think they had original masters to work with, a master tapes to work with, so they probably used CDs or vinyl or something that didn't give them quite as much range to work with. But you know, most of these Christian albums, it's what's left. A lot of them never had copies of the original masters. They've either been destroyed or lost, or they don't have access to them, so they got to kind of use what they've got. So they're a little brighter sounding, but still sound really good. Their second album, Straight On, which is considered kind of a classic in Christian music circles. It's got that great band photo, 70s band photo, but this one just has a ton of great, great tracks on it. This was from 79. But tunes like Living on the Edge of Dying, Jericho, of course the band's classic tunes of Enchiridion and Long Distance Runner, typically always played together and played in concerts all the time. Really good. And it closes out with the track Mary, which starts out acoustically and then kind of goes a little little harder at the end. This is just such a great album, one of the classics of the Christian genre. Lyrics on the insert, band photo and liner notes there. And this one's in a great, really cool red color. Very good album. It was one that when I first heard it in the 80s, I was like, ooh, it's a little too 70s for me. I don't know if I really like that. But it's grown on me so much, and now I just recognize it for the classic that it is. And then finally, their third album, this Gerda re-release of This Ain't Hollywood. This is from 1980 originally. They started to move into a little bit more pop territory and started to move away from some of their blues influences a bit. They did take on more of a kind of Doobie Brothers vibe in some tracks. Some of the vocals and songwriting kind of reflected that. You get a little Michael McDonald feel on some of these. Track style of This Ain't Hollywood is one of my favorites. When He Comes Back, Light of the World are kind of popular ones. All Night I think is really good. Over and Over is good. There's some good tracks on here. They're starting to move into that pop territory that their next album, Mission of Mercy, would kind of fully embrace, which that's the album my least favorite is Mission of Mercy, but this one still had enough of what made the first two albums so popular that I like it. And this one is in kind of a mint green vinyl color, but very good music. And again, these albums all are mastered pretty much the same, they sound, again, just a little brighter, but very good remastering overall, considering what they had to work with. So if you're interested in DeGarmo and Key, great 70s and early 80s Christian rock, really good stuff, really nice releases. You can get those at girder.com. So that does it for the kind of the new old releases. Let's move into looking at some of the original vinyl I picked up. Just last week, I was able to finally order and receive a copy of the Blood Good documentary, Trenches of Rock. which I'd never seen before. I finally had a chance to watch this in its entirety in great Blu-ray quality. Boy, this was phenomenal, phenomenal thing. If you haven't seen it yet, I highly recommend you to pick up your copy. Trenches of Rock is really, really well done. I wish more Christian bands had documentaries done to this caliber. And, you know, Petra could use this, Bride could use this, all sorts of great Christian hard rock and heavy metal bands could benefit from documentary done like this. Really well done. I believe it's done by Michael Bloodgood's son, and it does a really, really good job. Great piece. Anyway, I watched this, and it really got me in the mood for Bloodgood music again, although I've kind of been on a Bloodgood kick for a couple months now, actually. Trenches of Rock, the documentary ends, or kind of leads into their 2013 album, Dangerously Close, which was, you know, re-released on vinyl here in 2021 last year. So it kind of leads into that music, and it kind of stops there. It doesn't even go fully into that. So I think the documentary's timeline leads up to that recording process or that time. Listening to all that just really got me back into the mood for Bloodgood. And not too long ago, I'd picked up a sealed copy of Bloodgood's third album, Rock in a Hard Place. Still has the little hype sticker on it from Benson Spotlight. But I unsealed it, of course, and opened it up. This album has kind of a notorious history with Bloodgood. Their third album, they went a little more kind of polished hard rock as opposed to maybe metal. I like the album a lot, great stuff, but this particular, the mix of this album, I think got kind of cheated a little bit. I guess the bass doesn't come through really well, and it's just not a great mix. It's since been remastered for CD, but not for vinyl, and this is the original vinyl release from whatever year that was, 88. It's fun to have because I like the album. It doesn't sound awful, but it's not as great as the remastered CD. I'm expecting probably some point in time they're going to re-release this on vinyl. Gerger did, you know, the first two albums remastered and then did Dangerously Close with redone cover art and all that. But they haven't done Rock in a Hard Place or Out of the Darkness yet, which I expect those two probably will come out at some point. But I know with Michael Bloodgood's being in the hospital right now, it's kind of a touchy time with things. Fun to have this album. Fun to watch Trenches of Rock. If you haven't watched this, pick it up. From the Bloodgood website, it's really a good album. Then also, I've finally been picking up some of my old favorites. I got into Barnabas, hard rock, somewhat heavy metal, progressive rock band from the 80s, around the 70s and 80s, I guess. And Barnabas, Find Your Heart a Home here was their second album, I believe, and this is the reissue cover, the Light Records cover. They had a different cover for their initial release, but this is the reissue one. Found this at a local vinyl shop here months ago. It's fun to have that. Picked up my favorite of their album, Barnabas Approaching Lightspeed. Just a great classic album. Very, very guitar and keyboard driven, kind of synthesizer sounds and stuff like that, adds to the spacey atmosphere of the theme here. But really, this is my favorite Barnabas album. Of a product of its time, but a very good album. And then recently I just picked up Feel the Fire, their second to last album. And this one's similar to Approaching Light Speed in terms of style, but not quite as good as Approaching Light Speed, but it is good. And then I do have their last album, Little Foxes, coming on the in the mail too. And that one got back to a little rawer sound, a little more further removed from those previous two albums, Feel the Fire and Approaching Light Speed. But I'm kind of getting my Barnabas collection, because they had five albums out, Barnabas collection complete, because I really did like Barnabas a lot. And then also picked up the Swedish hard rock band Jerusalem, their second album called Volume 2. Picked up a couple editions of that. This one, and then one that was at a really good price that's still sealed and looks in pretty decent shape. A little bit of creasing and maybe some ring wear, but it's completely sealed. So I've got that and one that's unsealed to listen to. They're just good prices. I thought I'd pick those up. Picked up they're kind of one of their more famous albums and a favorite of mine, Warrior, and this is just a really good album too, of 70s 80s rock from Swedish band Jerusalem. And finally, just to kind of note, I picked up this Ed Ratzlaff album, Driving Wheels, kind of a blues Eric Clapton-ish rock, southern rock sound. I found this at Half Price Books for $5. I know Gerder just reissued two of Ratzlaff's CDs, including this one was one of them, on a remastered CD. So maybe somebody picked that up and then got rid of their vinyl copy. I thought for $5 I'd give it a shot. Anyway, that's what I've got today as far as some of the new remastered, re-released vinyl and some old original vinyl that I picked up recently. I think you'll find something if you don't already own these or are familiar with these. If some of these are new to you, I think you'll find something today and what I presented that will be of interest to you. Check out this music. There was some really good music that I presented here today. Good vinyl. I've listened to most of it. What I haven't, I'm going to go back and be listening to here soon, but lots of good Christian rock music out there. Anyway, next time we'll take a deep dive into Deliverance, Camelot in Smithereens, the Redux. I've been meaning to give that a full review and look at the music and the story. We'll be looking at that in my next vlog video. Until then, I'm Tim Risto. Have a good one.